We're alive. I think I'm good to go. And to be honest, I'm rather disorganized right now. It's also been a bit since I dealt with stuff. No, this is randomized, right? No, it isn't. No, it doesn't need to be randomized right now. Basically makes it to where if you have all four buttons held down, you're always gonna move up left. We'll be right back. there's one thing I could do. Files real quick. Players test two shots. 16x16. Yeah, I just literally made a half the size thing. Surprise. Okay, 48 by 48. Okay. Charge to shot with BMG. Okay. Save. I know you guys don't see any of that because no real need to. Howdy, Snowy, how you doing today? I just realized you guys can't see the test screen. Let me add a capture for that. There we go. Good. It's always good to be doing good. Be a lot better if I had more monitors. So, Definitely wouldn't be one of the first things I invest in on upgrading this thing. Script. Gosh. Mouthful of smog. Someone must be running their overcompensator outside. Hold on a second, closing windows. Those kids are just getting out of school, so it's probably a school bus or something. We'll reopen the windows in a bit. Anyways. Okay. Using other node, kinematic body tuning. Wrong thing. Neither should... Yeah, I know. Sprite! Boost. Silver bite marks, thank you for that far. Right now I am de-rusting my crusty brain of how to go about doing all this. There we go. Actually, before I do, collision shape 2D. Okay. What's your issue? Well, no dawn is easy. Howdy, howdy. It's a shmup. Something I've been working on for far too long. But hopefully this is the last time I'll need to remake it from the ground up. Trying to learn Godot, or Godot, however it's pronounced. Things aren't going to be the most exciting, but I'm more using the streams as a way of trying to get me to focus on working on this more. Even if I only work for a few hours in any given day, it's still more hours than I've been putting on an average in the past few years. And you can see what it looks like in the right, I believe, is where I put it on the OBS. This is pretty much all that there is right now of the Godot version, at least. I do have videos of when I was making this in Unity. I didn't get too far in that either. I'll steal this. Actually, I can just probably take both of these functions. We're gonna be doing something else. One. That is what I want to do, right? I forget how this works. I don't need to put a, whatchamajigga on the end. Okay. Let's try and do it over. It's colon equals. Speed times equals 2. Speed. See how that looks like. Made me switch engines. Working on a little game jam project called Tomomon. I finally got back into doing game design stuff after a while, and joined in a little jam. And so I updated my Unity to a certain thing, and the 2D animator just was broken in that version. It would not work. And I even looked for solutions, and they're just like, it just doesn't work. And so I basically had to code my own animator for it. And basically at that point, I was like, I already knew Unity wasn't exactly the greatest for 2D. I've always had issues with it, even when I was working with it professionally. But, after that, I started looking for alternatives, and been looking at Godot for a while, and so I've been trying to use that more. I did a tutorial last year, I want to say. I don't have it on this computer, though, because this is a new PC I just finished putting together this week. But, I did some tutorial. I think it was from a guy called GQuest on YouTube. That's how I have started learning, and now it's just me beating my head against the wall. GD Quest, I think that's it, yeah. One second, I think I'm going to use my other computer as a chat viewing. Because it's tough only having one monitor right now. Okay. Also going to get some water while I'm up. But yeah, I used to use Unity, and before Unity, I used to use Python. Minute for that PC to wake up, but yeah, all right. I don't remember what my inputs are. Project settings. Input map, here we go. Let's say UI select. Maybe. Yeah, I'll just use it. UI select. Input dot is action pressed. Select. Oh wait, no, I need the opposite of that. Thank you. Action. PC is almost ready. Does it need to be double equals? Dashboard. I do have a value for charge rate, right? Yeah, charge value. Charge value equals charge rate. So Elsif or Elif? I don't see me as anything. If statements go at, it is Elif. Thank you. LF. Input dot is action just released. Blink. Equal to 100. Charge to just charge. Make that. Instance. Yeah, there you go. Switch dance. Okay. It's not working. I did. Building code and support for Visual Studio Code. I'm not too fond of Visual Studio, personally. Today. Dread is 10. There's one way we can do this. Print. No matter how long I hold it for, it isn't fire. So what am I doing wrong here? Let's put one in a testing. It's flying off like instantly. Okay, that's an issue. Script, that's what I'm looking at. Okay. It's too slow now. No, the screen doesn't want to show the properties. There we go. About now. No. But two is out of the question, right? yeah. Two just goes nuts. 1.5. Nine, it's still going slow, but as soon as I set that to 2, oh boy! Oh, programming. Better. What if I put you at 0.1? I don't get it. How fast is this going? Pretty much. Let's comment this out. See what it goes normally. It's just crawling at a pace, snail's pace. Try it. No. Still moving at snail's pace. It's like it's not even applying. What is going on? It's like ignoring. The decimal. All right. Thank you for that. Hopefully that helps. There we go. Let's try that again. Quick as I'd like it to be, so let's bump this up. Shoom. Just keep tweaking it until it looks good. Yeah, there we go. Now for the next mystery. Why is that not going? You know if there's a way I can see values of things while debugging? I could do that in Unity, I don't know how to do it here. Like, I want to see what the value of my charge is on the ship. Without, you know, having to code in text thing for it. I mean, I'm gonna have to do that eventually, but you know, I kinda want to get the basic movement and stuff down now, before I do the UI. Thank you. Pulse value is working right. Thank you, by the way, in case I didn't say it. Action release, I think? Didn't seem to be complaining yet. So it isn't a thing. But it's still not working. Okay, I think I know a better way of doing this. Release. This should hopefully work. No. No, it's just not working. Thank you. Perfect, damn it. His action just release should be working, though. That's the weird thing. I didn't set the thing to, and I push the button again, so I'm gonna have to reset this again. Conflicting with the action pressed. I don't know the exact reason why, but that's life, I guess. Anyhow, making progress. George Pugh. I never name my layers? Thought I would have. transferring, I guess. Nope, it still pushes me. So it's shunting me. And what have I forgotten? Here we go. There we go. Now for my next trick, sizing wizardry. I'm gonna resize the window and resize the characters. Scaling actors, how about that? Hmm. I'm just not finding anything. See objects instead of actors. Okay. So here, let me just alright, take care. Thanks for coming by. Hey, Melon Speedruns, thank you for that follow. Oh, hey! Straw Bunny! Thank you for the raid. Welcome on in, everyone. You're just in time to see me suffering with Godot. Currently trying to deal with scaling. How is the stream, Straw Bunny? Why is my botnet live? Cool. One second. Do I do anything besides coding? I mean, I do pretty much everything myself. at this time. But right now, there's a lot of coding. What is here? Alright. Devour well. Why is my cloud bot off? Okay. There we go. Playing Breath of the Wild. Welcome on in, everyone. You know it. Thank you for that follow, Excalibur-nator. Thank you very much. Hope everyone is having a groovy day. Scale. Equals scale speed. That should be good. Alright, let's see how this looks. Increase the speed. There we go. That didn't take so long. What do I want to do next? No, we haven't looked at the enemies to see what they look like. Right, we just have nukes. Could swap over to doing sprites. Maybe. Howdy, Baku. trying to think, because I'm pretty sure we've done just about everything we really need to with the player for now. Enemy doesn't really need much work at the moment, just because it's a simple enemy. Actually, we do need some stuff. Greater than in my coding the game that I've been working on for nearly 10 years. It may sound astounding considering how little work has been accomplished on it, but this is pretty much my third or fourth time remaking it from the ground up. And I'm completely new to Godot, so I'm slowly learning it. Because this thing was originally going to be made in Python using Pygame plugins, and then I started it in Unity, and Unity is a dumpster fire when it comes to 2D stuff. So I eventually gave up on Unity and moved to Godot, where I am now. Anyways. JoeJohn95, thank you for that follow. JavaScript in SVG. I don't know what SVG is, but I definitely wouldn't code the game in JavaScript. I believe Unity supported JavaScript, and I think Godot supports JavaScript, but I don't hate JavaScript, but I'm not thrilled about it either. I kind of like Godot's language a bit, so I'm rolling with that. SVG is like HTML for artwork. Better way of doing this, but I don't care at this moment. Y is greater than 0. Global position dot y equals 0. If position dot y less than I don't really know my stuff too well right now. Easy peasy. Alright, let's test it out. No! Okay. So I have some adjustments to do. Oh wait. I'm silly, I forgot the minuses. Okay, left is good. Getting better. I think Godot uses like reverse. Good, that's good. That's good. Yep, that seems good. Sure what that's about. Probably also have something for you. If position dot x less than less than minus 100. So the enemies delete themselves now. Wait, no, I did the wrong thing. Above. There. Should be far better. I'm going to adjust it. So we'd be taking up system resources with off-screen shots for too far. DJ, do you know anything about what that person is talking about, by the way? A particular species of goat. I'll allow it, because it seems to be, it checks out for now, but I don't know. This reminds me of the mass other follows I've been getting lately. Wait, why did it get rid of that message? I did hit allow, didn't I? I did say allow. Yeah. But now it's gone. I don't know. Twitch is being weird. But JoJon, I saw your message. I'm approving it for now. I don't know why Twitch got rid of it though, even though I hit allow. Oh, to think of what else I can do today. It's getting close to dinner time for me, so I might wrap it up soon. Which might be a good idea, because I'm kind of running out of idea of what I can feasibly get done today. Savage. Thank y'all for coming out today, by the way. And thank you again, Shaw Bunny, for that raid, and Silver Bite Marks, Melon Speedruns, Excaliburnator, and JoJohn95 for the follows. Thank y'all. I appreciate you guys coming by and keeping me company. Especially as I am bashing my head against the proverbial wall here with trying to de-rust and learn Godot. Anyways, let's go give Savage some support. Take care, everyone.